Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part six of equations and graphs of ellipses, and we're going to write the equation of the ellipse below in standard form. It's given in general form. Then we're going to state the center and graph it. Then we'll check that one of the vertices satisfies the original equation below. That's a very important point to check. In fact, I just did this whole problem on a video, and when I checked, I found out I made a mistake when I was doing some canceling with fractions. So I found my mistake, and here I am doing the video over again. So it's always important to check your work. So here's the problem. We've got 9x squared plus 36x. We're going to group those together. And then we're going to group the y squared and y term together because remember what we want to do. We want to use completing the square to get it in the form we need, the standard form. So in the first set of parentheses, you want to factor out a 9. You want to factor out whatever the coefficient of x squared is. So it's not always going to be the greatest common factor, by the way. It's just factor out whatever's in front of the x squared. So we have x squared plus 4x, and we know we're going to add something here to make what's in parentheses a perfect square. And for the second set of parentheses, I'm going to factor out the 25, giving y squared minus 2y. And again, we're going to put something in here to make it a perfect square. And then make sure you realize you're going to whatever you add to the left side of the equation, we're going to have to add to the right side of the equation. The trick is when I add something on this blank right here, for this first blank, when I add it inside the parentheses, I have to remember that number gets multiplied by 9, so I'm really adding 9 times whatever that number is to the left side. Right, so I'm going to come down here and I want to figure out what the perfect square would be if it was x squared plus 4x plus something. That would be x plus half of 4 is 2, so this would be an x plus 2, which means the 2 squared is what would go up here on the blank. I know some people do this in your head. Perfect. You could just say half of 2 squared is 4. That's fine. And then over here, I also like to figure out what would go. I like to figure this out first. It's going to be y minus half of that 2 is 1, so 1 squared is what goes on this blank. So the tricky part, like I mentioned, is you're really, and I'm going to put this in red, you're really adding a 9 times 4 to the left side of the equation, so you have to add 36. And you're really adding a 25 times 1, which is 25. So we have to add 164, 36 plus 25 together, and that's 225. So it's not quite in standard form yet, because to be in standard form, remember that you want to have the problem equal to 1. The equation has to equal 1. And then in the numerator, you have x plus t squared. You don't have any coefficient here. So let's just begin by dividing everything by 225, so at least the denominator, I mean, the right side of the equation is 1. Let's see, I'm going to be careful in my canceling this time through. 9 goes into 25 how many times? Okay, so I'm going to divide 9 into 225. Let's see, that goes in 2 times. And 9 into 45. So you know what? That cancels 225. All right, how about 25 into 225? That goes in 9 times. I think how many quarters in 225? So these are now ones, and how convenient, because that's what I want. I want the numerators not to have coefficients in front of those parentheses. X plus t squared over 25 plus y minus 1 squared over 9 equals 1. So we've got the standard form. Now, if you would like, you can write this as 5 squared in the denominator and 3 squared in the denominator. And those are just as correct. Okay, that's a correct way of writing it. What's the center? That was one of the questions. The center would be, let's see, you have to look what's in the parentheses here. It's going to be negative 2 for the x, 1 for the y. Remember, it's whatever makes that parentheses equal to 0. So x would have to be negative 2, y would have to be 1. So now we have the equation that we want. So our next step would be to graph the equation. All right, so here's our original equation in general form. In green, we've got our equation in standard form so that we could easily see what the center is. So let's note where the center is. It's right here. That's not part of the graph, though. And you don't have to do this, but a lot of times I just like to draw the little vertical and horizontal line just to make little guides for myself, but not necessary. That's personal preference. All right, now how do we get points on the graph? From the center in the x direction, we're going to go 5 to the right and then 5 to the left. So we go 5 to the right, and we have this point here. And let's write what the vertices are right below. That's going to be 3, 1. That's one vertex. Okay, if we go 5 to the left, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we get this vertex, which is negative 7, 1. Right, how about up and down? So we've got 3. Now here, so from this point, I'm going to go up 3, 1, 2, 3. We're going to go down 3, 1, 2, 3. So there we go. Those are our guides. And now this isn't perfectly accurate, but we're just, sketching the ellipse. So something like that. In other words, I haven't got it going through necessarily the right places on the x-axis or the y-axis. We're just getting a rough sketch of this. So what were these last two? I had negative 2, 4. And I had negative 2, negative 2. So what I want to make sure of is I'm going to check my vertices. Like I said, I did this problem, and when I checked it, I found out I made a mistake. And that's how I found out I made a mistake. I checked my vertices at the end. So it doesn't matter which one of these vertices you check. So why don't you put the video on pause and try one of these ordered pairs in for your x and y into this original equation. Always check in the original equation, because that's the only thing that you didn't screw up on, right? You might have made a mistake on your very first step when you were to another equation. So go ahead and put the video on pause and try any one of these or all of them and make sure it's true. I'm going to check 3, 1. So we're going to plug in 3 for x. So we have 9 times, actually, I don't need a parentheses. 9 times, I'm going to put in 3 for x, so that's 3 squared. And then for y, I'm going to put in a 1, so that's a 1 squared. And then for x, I'm going to put in a 3. Y, I'm putting in a 1, minus 164. And the question is, does that equal 0? So we have 9 times 27 plus 25 times, I'm sorry, that's not 9 times 27, I'm ahead of myself here. 9 times 9, and 25 times 1. 36 times 3, I think, is 108, minus 50, and minus 164. So we have 81 plus 25 plus 108 minus, let's do this. We have a negative 50 and a negative 164. I think that's negative. Let's see, 164 and 50, that is 214. Of course, you could just put this in your calculator, but I find it easier to just do the arithmetic myself. Keeps my mind in good shape. And what do we have here? Let's add those three numbers. So we have 81, 25, and 108. So that's 1314. Carry the one. So that's going to be 214. So, oh. I get 214 minus 214. Yeah, that's true for sure. So 3, 1 is definitely on the graph, and you could check the rest of them as well. Now, I don't know if this looked familiar to any of you, but this I gave you this problem in standard form on Ellipses part 4. So I actually gave you this in standard form. Do you recognize it? And then I asked you to put it in general form, and you multiplied everything out, and we got this 9x squared plus 25y squared plus 36x minus 50y minus 54. We just went around the other way. We did it the hard way. If we start from general form to put it in standard form, that's more difficult. We have to do all that completing of the square, etc. But it is exactly the same ellipse written in two different forms. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.